Hi, today we have a Skoda Rapid. As you can see, the airbags are blown. The vehicle had an accident. So now I'm going to show you how to replace the airbags, how to reset the airbag module, and also how to replace the safety belts, because they are also with airbag and they are stuck, they don't work anymore. The airbag on the steering wheel is very easy to replace, but the passenger airbag is complete with the whole dashboard. So I'm going to show you how to remove the dashboard. I'm going to start by removing the steering wheel airbag. I have removed the airbag unit, also I have disconnected the connector. Now you can see on this side, with a small screwdriver, I am putting in and I am pressing the pin, and after that I can remove the airbag. It's also on the both sides. So now I need a 12 angle M12 to remove the center bolt of the steering wheel. Now I can remove the steering wheel. Next I'm going to remove the top plastic cover. That one is together with the instrument panel cover plastic. This one is easy to remove. Just pull on this side up, then towards, and also this one, just pull it towards you. Now I'm going to remove the instrument panel. There are two bolts with Torx 20. Now I have to disconnect the connector. Next I'm going to remove the lower plastic cover. There are two bolts here with Torx 25 and one at the bottom. Now I have to remove the flat cable. There are three bolts with Torx 20. Next I have to disconnect the indicator stalk for the lights, hazard switch, and also wiper. There is one on this side connector, and there is one on this side. First I am pushing the red button, and after that I can press the connector pin inside and I can pull it out. And now there is one bolt from the bottom, that is Torx 15. Next I am moving to the center console. I'm going to remove this plastic cover, and now we can see the four bolts that hold the radio. Now I'm going to remove this plastic cover. I'm gonna need to use a small screwdriver. Next, there is one plastic cover at the bottom here. Is this one, and now there are two bolts that hold the heating module. Now we can see the bolts. We have opened the two bolts. So now I can push inside the heater module. I am finished here. Next I am going to remove the hazard switch. I am going to disconnect the connector. And I am going to start removing bolts we have two bolts here with Torx 20. Also we have one over here, and later I will show you the other ones. Now I'm moving on the left side. I'm going to remove the light switch. I'm going to remove the these two bolts with Torx 25, and we have one over here, Torx 20, and one over here also with Torx 20. They are holding the dashboard. Now the safety switches they can be removed easily. On this side I have to remove this plastic panel with a small screwdriver, and now I can disconnect a connector for the lights level sensor, and also there is one bolt here, and there is one bolt at the top, that one is here. And don't forget the OBD connector that is over here. There are three pins, two on this side and one on this side, that needs to be pressed, and then it can be removed. Now I'm almost finished on the left side. I just have to remove this side panel. Just pull from the top. There are two metal pins that hold the side panel. Now I'm moving on the right side of the vehicle. I'm going to remove this side panel. Now we have three bolts for opening. This is one. Here we have second, and up over here is the third one. I have removed the bolts. Now I'm going to open the bolts from the glove box. There are four bolts with Torx 20, and now there are two bolts at the bottom. We have one over here and we have one over here. I have pulled out the glove box, but very slowly, because there is a connector for the passenger airbag switch. Now I have to disconnect the passenger airbag. I have to pull up this purple plastic, and after that I can remove the connector, and there are two bolts that hold the dashboard with 10 millimeter wrench. Now I'm going to remove the side panel, and now the dashboard is released, so I can pull it out and I can remove it from the vehicle. Now the dashboard has been removed, so now I'm going to install the new dashboard. I have installed the dashboard. Now I'm going to start returning the bolts. I'm going to start on the right side. I'm going to connect the airbag bolts first, and after that I'm going to install the two bolts that hold the dashboard on this side. Next I'm going to install the glove box. I have installed the glove box. Inside there are four bolts. Connect the passenger airbag switch, and on the lower side two bolts, Torx 20. This side also one bolt, Torx 20. Now I'm moving on the left side. I'm just going to install this side panel, and I'm moving on the left side. I have installed the two bolts on this side, two bolts at the lower side, two bolts of the fuses. Connected the light lever switch, and also inserted the OBD plug. Now to install this side plastic cover. Next I'm going to install this center bolt and the two bolts in the radio console. Next I'm going to install the two bolts for the AC module. They are from the lower side. I have installed the two bolts. Now I can connect the switches and I can install them also. And now I'm going to install the plastic cover from the lower side of the plastic. Now I can install the instrument panel. Now I can install the indicator stalk. Connected the wiring on both sides. One bolt with Torx 10. Now to install the plastic cover. Correction, sorry, I forgot the flap. Now I can install the plastic covers. First the lower one. 3 bolts with Torx 25. There are 2 here, 1 at the bottom. Now to install the top plastic cover. Now I can install the steering wheel. The steering wheel has a mark here and also on the steering column that needs to be aligned. Now to install the bolt. I have installed also the light switch. Now to install the radio. Now to connect the hazard light switch. Now I just have to install the side plastic covers. Now I can start the engine. Now I have to replace the safety belts. Now I'm moving on the safety belts because, as you can see, they are stuck also. They don't work because they are with they are connected with the airbag. And to remove them, first I have to remove this plastic cover, and there is a bolt with a Torx 20. Now you can see the bolt inside. Now I have to pull up from the lower side. I have to pull it out because up here is two plastic pins. They are stuck like this. So now I can open this bolt with a 12 angle M10. Now I'm going to open the lower bolt. There is a bolt behind the carpet. It's also with 12 angle M12. And I have to pull out this black plastic cover. There are 4 pins that hold this plastic. And also we can see the bolt that holds the safety belt. It's also with 12 angle M10. I have removed the bolt. So now I'm moving this plastic. I can remove the carpet a little. And I can see the lower bolt. Now the belt is disconnected. And I have to open these two bolts with Torx 25. And after that I have to disconnect the wiring for the airbag. To disconnect the connector, first we have to pull up the purple plastic, and after that I can disconnect the connector. And I have removed on this side. Now I'm going to install the other one. I just remove it from the plastic. And we can hear the bolts are clicking inside. That's why it's stuck. It's not moving. Here I have a new unit or the safety belt. Now you can see this one is not clicking and it's working like it should. Now I'm going to install it. Just to put the bolt back in, now you can see this one is working. I have installed the lower bolt. Now I'm going to connect the wiring like that. Next, I'm going to install the metal part over here, two bolts with a Torx 25. Now I'm returning the plastic on the belt and I can connect the belt at the top. And now I have to connect the belt on the lower side. As you can see below, there is a pin that the belt needs to be inserted into the pin, and after that it can be attached to the bolt. Now that the belt is tightened, I can return this plastic to its position, and after that I can install this plastic over here. I have returned the plastics. Now I'm going to return the bolt. Now to close the cap. Now the safety belt is working. And I have to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to shorten the video a little. I'm going to skip some parts. Just to show you, this belt is also tightened. We usually blow both belts. I'm finished on this side. So now I have to connect the vehicle on the diagnostic tester, so I can delete the fault codes of the airbag. Now I'm going to connect with the tester. Over the plug is below. I'm connecting with the airbag. There are no any fault codes in the system. So now I can start the vehicle. And the airbag lamp is off. Now the vehicle can work properly. This means I am finished. If you like to see more videos, please subscribe to my channel, like my videos, and thank you for watching.